Students, here we have been given two problems to form the partial differential equations. The first problem is form the partial differential equation by eliminating the arbitrary constants from z equal to x squared plus a into y squared plus b. We already know that if we have two arbitrary constants to form the partial differential equation, we require at least three equations. For this purpose, let us take the first equation as equation number 1. And procedurally, we have to differentiate with respect to x and y. First, we shall differentiate the given equation with respect to x. It is dou z by dou x. Looking into the right hand side, there are two terms. One is x squared plus a, another one is y squared plus b. When we are differentiating with respect to x, all other variables are treated as constants. Here y squared plus b is a constant. We shall take y squared plus b as a constant. It is y squared plus b. When we differentiate x squared plus a, the differentiation of x squared is 2x. The differentiation of a is 0. So it is y squared plus b into 2x. This can be modified as p is equal to, because dou z by dou x, as per notation, it is equal to p is equal to 2x into y squared plus b. This is numbered as equation number 2. Now let us differentiate the given equation with respect to y. It is dou z by dou y. X squared plus a is a constant, so x squared plus a is written as it is. The differentiation of the other term, y squared, is 2y. The differentiation of b is equal to 0. It is written as q is equal to, because dou z by dou y is q, q is equal to 2y into x squared plus a. This is numbered as equation number 3. Now, you look into the given equation, x squared plus a is coming in the bracket, y squared plus b is also coming in the bracket. So, we have to try to eliminate x squared plus a as a whole and y squared plus b as a whole. And we have to find the equivalent terms for x squared plus a and y squared plus b. From equation number 2, we can find out an equivalent equation for y squared plus b. Y squared plus b is equal to p by 2x. Similarly, from equation number 3, we can find out an equivalent equation for x squared plus a. X squared plus a is equal to q by 2y. Substitute 4 and 5 in equation number 1. In equation number 1, the left hand side is z, and you substitute for x squared plus a. It is x squared plus a is q by 2y, so q by 2y. You substitute for y squared plus b also, it is p by 2x. It is equal to p cubed divided by 4xy, cross multiply 4 into xyz, which is the required partial differential equation. The second problem is form the partial differential equation by eliminating the constants a and b from log of az minus 1 is equal to x plus ay plus b. Here also we have two arbitrary constants. This is a different kind of problem. Usually z will be given separately. Here it is coming inside the logarithmic function. And procedurally we can differentiate. First, let you take the given equation as equation number 1. Differentiating the given equation with respect to x, log of az minus 1 is of the form of log x model. It is a function of a function. So first, differentiate in the form of log x. The differentiation of log x equal to 1 by x. Instead of 1 x, here it has come az minus 1. So 1 by x can be written here as per the formula 1 by az minus 1. Now you differentiate the content inside the bracket once again. A is a constant. The differentiation of z with respect to x is dou z by dou x. It is written as p here. On the right hand side, the differentiation of x is 1. When we are differentiating with respect to x, all other variables are treated as constants. So the differentiation of ay is 0 and the differentiation of b is also 0. So this equation is written as equation number 2. Now let us differentiate the given equation with respect to y. And similarly, when we are differentiating with respect to y, the log of az minus 1 is taken as a log x model. So it is the differentiation of log of az minus 1 is 1 by az minus 1, and differentiating the content inside the bracket, a is a constant. The differentiation of z with respect to y now is q. On the right hand side, the differentiation of x is 0 and the differentiation of ay, a is as a, treated as a constant, a is written as it is, and the differentiation of y with respect to y is 1. The differentiation of the constant b is equal to 0. This is taken as equation number 3. Now our purpose is to form the partial differential equation. Now you look into the equation number 2. From 2 we get, you keep AP on the left hand side, AP is equal to AZ minus 1, and you move the 1 to the left hand side, 1 is equal to AZ minus AP, which is equal to A into Z minus P. From this we can find an equivalent term for A. A is equal to 1 by Z minus P. This is taken as equation number 4. And from 3 we get, look into the equation number 3, and 1 by AZ minus 1 into AQ, which is equal to A into 1. A gets cancelled with each other, and Q is equal to AZ minus 1, which is taken as equation number 5. Now substitute 4 in equation number 5. 4 is 4 in equation number 5. Q is equal to, for A we can substitute 1 by Z minus P into Z minus 1, taking LCM, Q is equal to Z minus of Z minus P. So expand this bracket and move this Z minus P to the left hand side. Q into Z minus P equal to Z minus Z plus P. This can be remodified as P into Q plus 1, which is equal to Z into Q. This is the required partial differential equation.